Should we proceed with learning outcome 3, advertising, pengiklanan dalam bahasa Melayu. Advertising is defined as any form of impersonal paid communication in which the sponsor or company is identified. Advertising is the most popular forms of promotions. There are two major types of advertising: institutional advertising and product advertising. Institutional advertising is a form of advertising designed to enhance the image of the companies rather than to promote a particular product. It is also known as the corporate advertising. It is more to create a positive image of the companies in the mind of the consumers. Number two is product advertising. In contrast with the institutional advertising, product advertising is a form of advertising that really explain the benefits of a specific product or services by the marketer. There are pioneering advertising, which is an advertisement intended to stimulate a primary demand for a new product. Then competitive advertising. Company will use competitive or brand advertising when normally product enters into a growth stages in the product life cycle. Examples like when an automobile manufacturer such as Proton or Produa, they will highlight in the advertisement of their product such as the quality, performance and image of their cars. And then comparative advertising, where these forms of TV advertisement is actually to make a comparison between one product to another. Like examples in Malaysia, you can see that in some TV advertisement about detergent, a company will make a comparison between product X versus this one product. In advertising, a major decision for the marketers is the choice of medium or media, the channel used to convey a message to the target market. There are six medium can be used by the marketers in advertising. Number one is newspaper. Number two, magazine. Number three, radio. Number four is television. And number five, outdoor media. And number six, internet. The types of media use is actually influenced by the cost of the marketers, how much money the marketers want to spend for the advertisement. And number two, the types of product that they want to sell. We are going to look into the advantages and disadvantages of these six different medium and what are the best option that the marketers can have from these different six types of medium. Number one is newspaper, and of course newspaper, one of the advantage is much more cheaper and can go for a broad market, because in those days people normally read newspapers. But in terms of disadvantages, advertiser cannot go creative when they do the newspaper advertisement, because normally newspaper advertisement is in the forms of words and lack of colors. Number two is magazine. One of the good things about magazine is it is very creative and also designed for a particular product for a particular magazine. Examples like if you want to buy product of landscaping, you can go and buy majalah Laman. That actually in that magazine you can find a lot of advertisement about landscaping products. Okay, number three is of course one of the popular medium, which is radio. One of the good things about radio is that it actually can go for a broad market and it is easily reachable by the consumers, because most Malaysian consumers are listening to radio. But one of the bad things about radio, there is no visual or picture of the product when you listen to a radio and heard an advertisement of the product.
Sambut bulan bermakna dengan penjimatan hebat Tasco. Promosi hari ini.
Number four, beside radio, of course, the most popular is through TV advertisement. Why? Because most of us watching TV every day. So it is more reachable to the consumers, and with the visual opportunities, marketers can really visualize the product in the mind of the consumers. But one of the disadvantages of using TV is actually the cost. Out of all media, television advertisement is the most expensive types of media that can be used by the marketers. Number 5 is outdoor media. Examples like you can see when you go along the highway in Malaysia, those billboards is an examples of outdoor media. The big billboard that appears along the highway. Or you can see other printed advertisement in the railway station or LRT stations. In terms of outdoor media, it is more flexible, and also in terms of cost, it's moderate and not as expensive as radio and television. But then the bad things about outdoor media is the short messages that can be used. And then number 6 is internet advertising, which is, I think these are the things that right now one of the good media that can be used by the marketers. Internet advertising is the fastest growing medium right now because it's able to reach a very narrow and very broad target audience. Examples of internet advertisement is YouTube advertisement, Facebook advertisement, all these social media advertisement. And you also can come across when you go for certain websites, there are what we call it as a pop-up banners, the website banners or the link. When you click here, you can go to navigate to other websites. But the disadvantages of internet advertising is because of not all consumers have access to internet, especially in certain rural areas as compared to televisions. So as a marketer, out of these 6 different types of medium, they need to do a media planning, which types of media that they want to use based on the cost that they have and also based on the types of product that they want to market to the target market.